you are working with an unpublished app, you can create master items that can be reused in other visualizations. In this tutorial, you'll learn how to create master measures and master dimensions, create master items with a basic aggregation function, edit an expression in master dimensions and measures, and create master visualizations. Now we will demonstrate how to create a master dimension, starting from the Fields section of the Assets panel. The same procedure can be used to create master measures. In the Field list, select the field you want to use as a dimension. In the Preview window, select the Create Dimension icon. A dimension can be single or drill down. In this case, we select single. As you can see, the field name is also used as the name of the dimension. You can change the name and enter a description as well as tags. Select Add Dimension and then click on Done. The dimension is saved in the Dimensions category in the Master Items. You can now use it in other visualizations throughout your app. Another way to create a master item is from the Asset panel. We can create a drill down dimension. Choose at least two fields and insert them as the referenced fields. This capability usually requires extensive modeling or complex scripts in other BI software products. But with Qlik Sense, creating a drill down dimension is a simple selection process. Insert a name and description, and save by clicking Add Dimension. The dimension is now saved to the master items. If you select the dimension, the preview displays the dimension type and which fields are included in the drill down. You can insert calculated expressions in master dimensions and measures to calculate KPIs within an application. You can type your expression directly in the expression field, but you won't be able to check for syntax errors. Alternatively, you can open the expression editor and enter an expression. In this case, the expression editor checks for possible errors in the syntax as you type. In the expression editor, you can choose if you want to show fields from a particular table. You can add a basic aggregation function by selecting the fields and the expression aggregation from the drop-down menu. Click on Insert to add the expression in the editor. The expression editor allows you to add more complex expressions. In this example, we are calculating the average sales per customer. When done, click Apply to add the expression. The measure is saved in the Measures category in the Master Items. You can now use it in visualizations throughout your app. The last category of objects in the library are visualizations. How you create a master visualization is different from how you create measures and dimensions. You can easily add a visualization to the master items by dragging it from a sheet to the master items. If you have given the visualization a title, this is automatically added as the name of the master visualization. You can change other information associated with the visualization or leave it as is. Another way to create a visualization as a master item is to right-click on the visualization and select Add to Master Items. Master items are visualizations that are typically the most popular or requested visualizations. They are created to make it easier for the user to analyze the data and can be easily dragged and dropped onto a private sheet. When you create master visualizations, the users of a published app will have access to them in their library, but will not be able to modify them.